On Earth, an iconic landscape is not the same without a bird's eye view of a 400 feet flying drone. The same goes for 33.9 million miles away on Mars. Seen so far in the Martian sky will change everything. Engineers at the Jet Propulsion Laboratory in Pasadena, California are developing 1 kilogram drones. These tiny helicopter scouts will be a revolutionary added value to NASA's Mars rover to make the trip and be autonomous in such a hostile environment. A robotic helicopter on Mars has many more challenges than here on Earth. For starters, the air on the red planet's atmosphere is fragile. Over millions of years, the sun's pressure stripped the lighter molecules from the atmosphere, making an extra skinny just 1% as dense as our home planet. As a result, a little chopper wouldn't need bigger blades or a faster spin rate. And since Mars' atmosphere is 100 times thinner, flying a typical helicopter would be the equivalent of flying at the height of 100,000 feet. Yet, that's just one of the challenges. Another engineer puzzle is how stable it can be once it takes the Mars skies, how it can land safely on unannounced rocky terrain. And the same small detail, there is no mechanic over there if something suddenly breaks. So it had to be durable. After all, it would carry much sensitive equipment. Counter-rotating propellers to cope with thin air, long-lasting batteries recharged with solar power, a high-resolution downward camera for getting its GPS, strong landing gears, and a reliable communication system to communicate with the rover down below. So does one important word, autonomy, which surrounds all that. The more autonomous the little chopper can be, the better the mission's overall success. Getting those extra 330 feet above the ground for NASA would be an enormous advantage over the dangerous terrain, pointing the rover towards a safer route. In addition, the airtime will be around 90 seconds, a great symbol of progress since humanity's first flight of the Wright brothers lasted 12 seconds. These humankind's first flights on another planet would be almost 900% longer. A 900% will cover 2,000 feet each day and have individual daily flights of 3 minutes. The 330 feet high overhead images will be 10 times better than the spacecraft orbiting Mars, and it will cover a much greater distance than can be seen from the rover's perspective. It would be an insane complementary asset and a privileged bird's eye of such a vast and unexplored terrain. The Mars helicopter project is still in early development. Despite this, the project made immense progress last year, succeeding in several tests on a 25-foot vacuum chamber. Pumping down density inside the chamber takes Mars on Earth and demonstrates that those blades can lift under extreme conditions. Meanwhile, our Perseverance companion, currently on Mars, has a catchy name, Ingenuity. A proper name, since the most challenging humanity's first explorations come from a core sense of ingenuity, and that thriving force will always overcome that famous question that starts it all, what if? Yet, this early development drone will have some challenges since engineers can't control it remotely. It would have to fly 34 million miles from home alone. It will be completely alone in the air and needs to respond according to wind gusts to maintain stability. Always in space, one mistake could be the last. Nobody has flown around Mars before. The heavy weight of cameras and computers of older drones for them to autopilot safely made it impossible to achieve that. These brand new drones will be packed with super lightweight microchips equivalent to cell phone processors from a couple of generations back. And those old cell phone microchips are some of the most powerful computers ever sent to outer space. With our current technology, in August, Ingenuity flitted across forbidden dunes for the Perseverance rover. It would be impossible to achieve that without some flying. Scouting the ground for Perseverance is the primary Ingenuity mission. The small helicopter is a test vehicle not designed in its entirety for scientific research, yet that will change when highly capable drones get on Mars. One thing is a tiny helicopter flitting across dunes. Another is an advanced drone 330 feet in the air, exploring caves, unseen landscapes, and high cliffside walls, taking historical images of places we could never reach without it. Yet, the revolutionary technology will not only help the exploration of Mars, NASA has even farther places to fly around. NASA will send out a drone the size of a small car to Saturn's moon, Titan. While Mars is about 34 million miles away, Titan is far into the galaxy horizon at 1 billion miles from Earth. Titan is worth the trip since it has a perfect atmosphere to fly, a thick atmosphere, and not a lot of gravity, making it an ideal place for this immense drone. But before all that, Ingenuity is the first to make progress in giving scientists the first substantial evidence about how it would be to fly on other planets. And even though Ingenuity is not flying per se, it is waiting for Perseverance to catch up. Ingenuity on April 19, 2021 was the first ever aircraft to fly on another world with a historical 39-second flight. Currently, it is facing the harsh Martian winter, and it has made sounding progress, graduating from just a prototype to a driving scout for the rover traversing a 3.5 billion year mysterious and iconic planet. A helicopter for the rover and Ingenuity will be a dream come true for Martian exploration, and the first monumental step to start flying toward other planets far beyond our imagination, like Venus, Titan, or even gas giants like Jupiter and Saturn. The possibilities next to this drone's first steps will open many unknown doors for engineers. Unexplored caves, canyons, and craters are just a few prototypes away. And Ingenuity is making solid progress toward that ambitious direction, overcoming expectations. Initially, the team behind the tiny helicopter hoped for only 5 test flights before it died, yet the small 4-pound helicopter still functions perfectly. Aerodynamics predictions for the small helicopter have allowed plans for 44-pound, well-thought, designed, and powerful science copters. The transition from prototype to scout, Ingenuity points towards a new direction for conquering the Mars sky, making them exceptionally useful for guiding rovers. The success of this small copter has made NASA scientists wonder what would happen with better flight conditions. That's why they set their sights on Titan with the mission of Dragonfly, a long-term goal that will be possible around 2034. Mars conditions for flying are terrible, yet a prototype did unexpectedly well. In better conditions and with a more significant project, the results could be immense advances for space exploration. The Dragonfly mission will be a complete mobile flying science lab weighing 926 pounds, powered by a nuclear battery with the most advanced sensors to safely land like a feather on a much more gentle atmosphere than Mars. Gentle in the sense of gravity, since Titan has a surface temperature of minus 297 degrees Fahrenheit if we look at the thermostat. Essentially, Dragonfly will be a flying rover that withstands such a cold environment. The atmospheric entry to Titan and all the trips until the surface will be a soft, guaranteed landing. Engineers don't need expensive and powerful rockets to land a probe. The low gravity is crucial in making the Dragonfly mission so affordable. An astronaut on Titan could fly by flapping glider wings. This is because Titan's gravity looks similar to the Moon's. Someone weighing 220 pounds here would feel like weighing 30. That forgiving gravity doesn't mean it will be an easy mission. It is just one less thing to worry about. The terrain is extremely dangerous a billion miles away. Once over there, the Dragonfly mission will have to look out for stray gusts if it succeeds. The air may be the next frontier, yet after that, NASA can start thinking about how it could also explore Titan's methane seas. All thanks to the unprecedented progress Ingenuity makes on Mars. A small copter that was thought to be a short-term prototype is currently on its 30th mission, surviving again after losing communication due to a lower power from its solar panels in the middle of Mars winter. Currently, the timeline is Mars, Titan, and maybe Venus. Ingenuity is the beginning of a revolutionary technology that could fly amongst sulfuric acid clouds on Venus one day. NASA can set its sights on more ambitious missions thanks to the last progress made in the previous decade. This progress is reflected in every instrument, from batteries to designs to materials. And now, engineers can redo all those specific parts to make it lightweight enough to conquer the skies a billion miles away. But what do you think? Is this the first milestone to conquering the skies ahead? Tell us in the comments below.